Hi guys, Maximilian Color here. Welcome to the first video of my kind of guide series for Counter-Strike and mainly competitive Counter-Strike. This first video is going to be kind of just an introduction on like the basics. I'm going to show you how to set up your Counter-Strike, your video options, and everything else that's important for just in general to make you a better Counter-Strike player, but also for competitive CS. If you want to get into competitive CS, if you're bored of just playing pub servers, you know, that does get really boring. And in my opinion, and a lot of other people's, competitive CS is definitely the way to go. It's a lot of fun when you get to a level where you can actually play with good players and get good teams and stuff. So I'm going to start off here with the mouse, configuring your mouse, disabling acceleration. Acceleration is something that comes with Counter-Strike 1.6 as a default. And so it's something that's very important for beginners, or just it's something that's very important to fix and get rid of. So you start off by opening your games menu here. You right click on Counter-Strike, go to Properties, click Set Launch Options, and this is what you type in here. These are two. There's one more called dash no force and SPD, and that's an additional command that you can. These are all commands for disabling acceleration, and this additional command. If you really want to, you can test it yourself to see exactly what it does, the feel. But it provides a little bit of a different feel, and a lot of people don't like that, so we just leave it out, including me. And those are the only launch option commands that I use, but there are actually a lot more. And I'm not sure if I'm going to go over them with you in this video, because they're not really necessary. And then the second thing you want to do is go open your control panel, click on mouse, come to pointer options over here, and you want to make sure that enhanced pointer precision is unchecked. This slider is also important. If you have a 400 DPI mouse, you want to keep it on the middle here, at 6, 11, there's 11 notches. You don't want to have it any higher. Some people that use really, really low sensitivity, they will put it to like 5, and then they'll use like a really large mouse pad, and they'll be moving the mouse like all across it. But most people are fine with, if you have a 400 DPI mouse, just leave it on the middle. If you have a higher DPI mouse, like 1600 or 1800, even 2000, most people would put it to 3 of 11, because that's about the same speed as in the middle with a 400 DPI mouse. Of course it varies a little with, 1600, 2000 DPI, of course it's gonna be a difference, but yeah, about 3 of 11 is what most people use. All this stuff does make a difference though, it is important. If you want more technical information about it, you can check on Gotfrag. That's where I saw different articles about all this stuff, links. So search on there, and Gotfrag.com, or you can make a post and ask about it. There are also a couple different programs that are called mouse fixes, and they edit the registry or other things to disable this, Microsoft's default acceleration. I mean, normally you can just uncheck enhanced pointer precision, and it'll disable that, but a lot of people like to go to extremes and use mouse fix. There's one called CPL mouse fix that seems to be the most popular. Some people use that, and then just uncheck enhanced pointer precision, and then use that with the... Actually, they use it instead of the no force commands. So you can try that if you want. It's not really necessary, it's just another way to disable mouse acceleration. And that also, I think, affects other games too. If there are any other games with mouse acceleration on, it'll probably affect those too, so that may be something you want to try. But Gotfrag.com is pretty much your... it's pretty good for just anything to do with Counter-Strike. I mean, that's where the community is, the forums there, the news, demos, anything you want to do with competitive Counter-Strike. That's a really good site for that. So that's pretty much it with that, and then you should have no acceleration right now in Counter-Strike. And then the next thing, if you have a newer mouse, there's probably options in like the GUI or the if you have a Razer mouse, there would be a Razer control panel where you could edit the mouse hertz, is what it's called. It's like how fast the mouse updates, and that's very important. If you have just a regular older mouse, like I'm using a 3.0 IntelliMouse, and I have to set it myself, and there are a couple programs that we use for that. Older program that most people use was this one. It doesn't work anymore with Windows XP Service Pack 3, as well as newer operating systems. And then there was this one that was very useful because you could check your mouse hertz, which you can still check it, but you can't set them anymore. That was good because you didn't have to restart your computer in safe mode, but this one you did. But mouse hertz is another one that you can use to check the hertz. So here you can see the average, and then here it's really fast. It's kind of spiking up, but if you move it fast, and it shouldn't spike as much, and then when you move slower, they just naturally, they don't go as high. But HID-USBF, this is the program that you can use with Windows XP Service Pack 3. I'll go over real quick, there's instructions in there, so I don't want to make the video too long. Just read me, there's installation instructions, you just follow it accordingly. So that's something you probably, if you have an older mouse, you can definitely set it to at least 500 hertz. It'll make your mouse movement smoother, it'll make it more responsive, and it's a very important thing to have. It even affects things like your recoil control, so it's definitely an important thing you want to have. And on newer mice, you can set them up to like 1,000, and sometimes, you know, they even go way over that by themselves, but I think the maximum setting right now is 1,000. The next thing would be your video options. Reforce is a great program. Okay, like, if you didn't use Reforce, what you would do is you would come here, you would go to Set Launch Options, and you would type in -FREQ, and then either if you have an LCD, you would put 75, and then if you have a CRT, you would put 100, because that's just what they can handle. All the newer LCDs, there's like really new ones that come out that can support up to like 120, but yeah, most of them only support 75. So you could either just do it like that, but the thing is with doing it in the No Force, but using the launch command, is that it doesn't affect other games. And if you use Reforce, you can set it for everything. Everything that runs in like 1024 by 768 will run in 100 hertz because I have it set on there. If you're going to use Reforce, or even if you don't use it, it's just in general a good idea to have updated drivers for everything. Like on my monitor, it says on the front, it says OptiQuest Q115. So I would Google that, and that brings me to a page where I can download drivers for my monitor, and after I install those, it actually lets me set higher frequencies for everything. And I have all mine set to 100 max, but I can show you what it would look like if I hadn't already set it. You would open it up, and it would pop up like this. You would just click, you make sure to have the active monitor selected, and then you'd click auto-populate, and then like it comes even up to 160 on lower resolutions. Now this is because I have a CRT monitor, so I can handle higher frequencies. And but for Counter-Strike, you don't really need like really high frequencies, so you can test it yourself again. Like all this stuff, you can test yourself, but I've extensively tested all of this, and a lot of other people have too. And 100, when I set it to 100, it just feels more in sync. It feels like it just runs smoother. I like it a lot better. I seem to get better registry, you know, things like that. And I did the same for 800 by 600. So I just have everything maxed at 100, and then, you know, the other ones, they can't go that high, so I just leave them alone. And you can apply. Yes. Okay. And that's that. You can right-click. You can right-click on your desktop. You can right-click on your desktop.